Ricciuto at centre wing. Oh, good grab by Wren. Handled at the hall. Hall left foot. Jarman, half volley. Left foot round the body. Misses. Oh, should have gone. Really should have gone.
Wouldn't be surprised if he gets dragged off the ground for that. He should have kicked that goal.
Yes, but the positive for the Adelaide Crows is that I think Ford Pocket is an absolute Monty for Andrew Jarman. He could kick 40 or 50 goals down there. It would really add another string to his bow and allow perhaps him and McDermott to play on the one side successfully.
Laidley from half-back. Capuano Oshenko's off the ground for North Melbourne. Pittman will try and paddle it to McDermott. McDermott to Kluzek. Now Kluzek's got some options. Jarman is the pocket. Got him.
So talented, a one-on-one position. If the ball is given to him, pretty good move this by Robert Shaw.
Well, he's highly skilled and he's tucked away in the pocket.
And twice he's beaten Blakey just with use of the body.
An important kick like what they all are, but Jarman with his high skills, you'd give him a real chance from here. And if he's going to make a go at the Ford Pocket, Jared, he's going to have to kick a few of these over the years. They're tough, I know. Going to try the banana. Oh, it's all right. The old check side, it's a goal. No substitute for skill. 7-12 to 5-7. It's a handy break again for the Crows. They're out to 17 points.
Well, a banana kick from about 35 metres. Pretty important kick that was.
Surely the important thing, Jared, for the Crows is that each time North Melbourne make a charge at them, they're able to steady and kick an answering goal fairly quickly.
Yes, they've been pretty good at that all night, Robert.
So Andrew Jarman, with his second goal, makes the margin again 17 points. They force the ball towards their half-forward line, the Crows. McGuinness caught, but he got his left foot to it. Modra, slippery little hand pass. Brown may goal from here. David Brown goes for goal. Off to the left.